In today's chapter, we'll look at the practical details of how to use or manage the tool. Here is a page created for a design called Phase On. Click here to close and expand. We click on the frame tool. Now we see a design tab on the right side. There are many design properties. Various frame sizes are supported for phone, tablet, desktop, presentation, watch, paper, and social media. If we want to design a device frame-wise application, we can quickly select the device-wise frame and click on it to link it to our design system. In phone tab, different phone frame sizes given. We can make frame according to our requirement. There are various tablet frames in the tablet tab from which we can create size-wise frames. Similarly, there are different desktop frames in the desktop tab. Different presentation frames in the presentation tab. Different watch frames in the watch tab. From there, we can create size-wise frames. If we need a frame related to paper, we can take the paper frame we need from the paper tab. Also, if you need a frame for a social media post or cover, you can easily create it from this tab. We have created a desktop frame from here. Then here we will go into details about the tool. This is the move tool used to move any object. This is the scale tool. Using this, we can resize this desktop frame according to the ratio. We created the frame using the frame tool, which we saw a little earlier. This is a slide tool. Which can cut out a specific area and export it separately. To remove a vector, frame or any object, select it from here and press delete from the keyboard to delete it. You can create a rectangle shape by clicking on the rectangle tool. You can easily move the shape by enabling the move tool. By clicking on the line shape tool, we can create line shape as needed. To straighten the line, you can create a line by holding Shift from the keyboard. And to make the contour point bigger and smaller, you can hold down on the mouse and drag it. Similarly, we can create an array by selecting the array tool and dragging the mouse on the frame. And if it is necessary to rotate, then if the mouse pointer is moved a little in front of it, the pointer is like a rotated icon. Then I can hold down the mouse and rotate it. Ellipse can be created with this tool if necessary. If you want to make 100% circle, you have to create ellipse by holding shift from the keyboard. To create a polygon shape, click the polygon tool and drag the mouse over the frame. We can customize the shape from the option on the right side. You can create a stroke shape by clicking on this tool. If you need an image in the design, you can easily take the image from our local meshing from the place image option. I can copy and paste the image here. This is the pen tool. You can easily create the polygon vector by dragging with it. And the vector can be controlled by accessing the point of any vector. This pencil tool can be used to draw anything as desired. If any text is required, we can generate the text using this text tool. Using the hold tool, we can hold the entire frame and move it. By selecting a specific area using this comment option, while working team wise, we can add feedback to each other. The other party will resolve that opinion. Thank you.